Hello everyone, welcome to MRCP part 2. In this video, we'll be discussing common pathologies of the pancreatic duct.
These are thick slab MRCP images in a patient with cholelithiasis showing loop-shaped configuration of the main pancreatic duct. This is an anatomical variant and an incidental finding.
This is a thick slab MRCP image of a patient with carcinoma gallbladder. The main pancreatic duct is seen to form a confluence with the terminal CBD and drain into the major duodenal papilla. An accessory duct is seen arising from the main pancreatic duct, forming a small loop, crossing the CBD and draining into the minor papilla. These findings are consistent with ANSA pancreatica, which is a predisposing factor for pancreatitis. Here is another example of ANSA pancreatica. An accessory pancreatic duct is seen arising from the main pancreatic duct. It is seen to descend down, then ascend upwards, forming a loop, crossing the CBD, and finally terminating into the minor papilla. Findings consistent with an ANSA pancreatica. These are thick slab MRCP images of a patient with acute on chronic pancreatitis. The main pancreatic duct can be seen to cross the CBD and drain separately into the minor papilla. The common bile duct joins the ventral pancreatic duct and drains into the major papilla of duodenum. Same findings seen on this image. The MPD is seen to cross the CBD and drain into the minor papilla. Here is the ventral duct which joins the common bile duct and drains into the major papilla of duodenum. These findings are consistent with pancreas divisum. These multiple hyperindense areas are likely necrotic areas in pancreatic parenchyma. Thick slab MRCP images in this patient show a dilated main pancreatic duct. CBD is prominent with abrupt cutoff of terminal CBD. Confluence of CBD and main pancreatic duct is not visualized. This is the so-called double duct sign. This patient had a lesion involving the uncinate process of pancreas. Coronal thick slab MRCP and T2 non-fat site images show variant pancreatic ductal anatomy with dilated duct of Virsung. Dilated duct of Virsung is seen to join CBD and drain ventral pancreas at the major papilla. Main pancreatic duct is dilated with dilatation of the side branches. Communication is seen between dilated main pancreatic duct and dilated duct of Virsung. A small outpouching is seen along the lateral aspects of main pancreatic duct with a thin channel which possibly represents duct of Santorini draining into the minor papilla. To recapitulate, variant pancreatic ductal anatomy is seen with dilatation of duct of Virsung joining the CBD and draining ventral pancreas at the major papilla. Main pancreatic duct is dilated with dilatation of side branches. It is possibly draining into minor papilla via a thin channel representing the duct of Santorini. Communication is seen between the dilated main pancreatic duct and duct of Virsung. Overall, these findings are suggestive of incomplete pancreas divisum and is the likely cause of recurrent pancreatitis in this patient. This MRCP image in a patient with chronic liver disease shows the main pancreatic duct forming a wide loop, joining the terminal CBD to form the confluence. First and third part of duodenum can be appreciated with fluid contents within. Second part of duodenum is, however, not well visualized. Coronal T2 weighted images of the same patient shows the pancreatic parenchyma completely encasing the second part of duodenum. However, no obvious proximal dilatation or obstruction is seen.
These findings are consistent with complete annular pancreas. Thank you for watching the video. If you liked the video, please press the like button, subscribe to our channel, and press the bell icon for notifications.